Episode 3.
Let's go.
It's going to be so proud of you guys.
I'm really excited.
I'm sure this is going to be very exciting.
I'm sure that it's going to develop the story substantially and not be a complete waste of time.
There's
going to
be some really good battle scenes, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
They will talk to each other like normal people. That would, yeah, I read that, yeah.
I'm excited for the long pauses in which nothing happens.
That's my favorite part.
I was actually going to say, those parts are pretty cool. To try and move from just saying this is going to be, because we talk about it almost every time we cover these fucking shows, filler, it's like, what's happening? It's we all got to get Thrawn, got to get him, and maybe Ezra or something, even though that guy is probably Ezra. So what's the dealio with that? And it's like, well, we need coordinates on that map. We found it already, but it's not in the hero's hands, and they didn't get the info from it. It's with the baddies. They've got it, and they're doing the Eye of Sauron or something, and they're going to go and fly over there, but they haven't done it yet, and the heroes just found out where they were. And so you might expect as a viewer that this episode could be like a 40 minute thing, and we're gonna battle the good versus bad, and that it'll end with a climactic thing of they all travel forward into that mysterious new galaxy, and maybe they arrive and there's a big cliffhanger on what they see immediately. Or we'll get what I would call, it's like the bad filler where nothing will fucking happen this episode. I guarantee it. Why? All of the stuff I just said about moving on with the map and the Eye of Sion or whatever the hell it's called is going to be something we do another time. It ain't going to be this episode.
I think it's because the structure of these Star Wars shows is becoming a little too transparent. You start to notice that things matter the most in the first couple episodes and then in the last couple of episodes.
Yeah.
And then in between.
How do our good guys know where to go? Because I thought the map was destroyed by the robots.
They put the tracker
They put the tracker on the ship we haven't learned their lesson.
That tracker got there through very legitimate means.
Shut up.
Yes, it's true. That's true. Yeah, that was an action-packed sequence.
People on that ship thought, that ship just followed us for like 2 minutes and didn't shoot at us. I wonder if it was a tracking thing on our ship.
It flew up right next to us, and then once it got next to us, it left.
A robot, a robot threw it.
Episode 1 ends with them getting the map and then flying away. They could have put a tracker on then, and we could be beginning with this episode.
And they could have not lost it in the first place, you know?
It's like true.
The bad guy's getting the hyperdrive piece. That could have just been something that was done already. It didn't need to be something that wasn't done.
But I mean, they have 8 episodes.
That's the crazy... so that was actually going to be what I was going to say. It's so sad that, like, it needs to be filled as opposed to 8 episodes. That's all I've got. I have so much story to tell. How exciting. I'm going to have to find a way to get it all in.
It doesn't feel like there's a lot of story to tell.
No, it doesn't feel like there's any story to tell. Finding Thrawn could have been done in episode 1.
If it was written better, it could have been done later. But yeah, it could have happened in episode 1.
I don't give a fuck. I need to understand this character before I care. But... Right now, we're running on the whole, like, he's good in Heir to the Empire, a book that has nothing to do with this, really.
He's in
at all.
Rebels a lot, and he's not very good in Rebels.
Yeah, because people keep saying they're going to ruin him, but then they're like, well, no, they already ruined him. It's like, oh.
Well, that's fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
They try to do the thing where he's, like, very quietly authoritative, but instead he just constantly sounds, like, sleepy. Like, he just rolls out of bed.
I assume he's Tywin-ish, or an archetype that's similar.
They're trying to make him Tywin-ish, yes. But because it's a kid's show, he has this habit of sparing our protagonists because of, like, quote-unquote, honor shit or whatever. Or, like, on the implication that he wants to see what they do next or something when he just has them dead to rights.
Yep.
That's the kind of, that's what you learn in first day of villain class. When you have the heroes, in your prison, or you have guns pointed at them, just to fucking kill them.
It's kind of the nature of having a hero encounter a villain, is that there's only so many times that you can have that happen before there has to be a confrontation that ends the conflict. I had this thought as well after the last episode about how, in terms of trying to make action scenes happen, and particularly lightsaber battles, that we have seriously devalued lightsaber battles in Star Wars. It used to be that when there was a battle, there was a significant consequence at the end of that battle. In A New Hope, Obi-Wan dies. In Empire, Luke loses his hand. Return of the Jedi, the battle, you know, Vader loses his hand, loses his lightsaber, and it ultimately culminates in the destruction of the Emperor. In episode 1, Qui-Gon and Darth Maul die. In episode 2, Anakin loses his arm. In episode 3, Anakin gets turned into Darth Vader. Every time that they have a lightsaber battle, the outcome matters. Here, we saw it in episode 2. Ahsoka had that battle with that new guy. but it's just there so that they can have the delay fight, and he can get away so that they can have another fight again, and there'll probably be another lightsaber battle. There'll be several of them where it happens, and it's just a thing that occurs, but the consequences are really, like, not significant at all. Well, here's where you're wrong.
Sabine got stabbed.
Yeah, that'd be an example to point to. They had a fight, she got hurt, but she was totally fine next episode. It was just there so that they could have a fight. It's seriously... I just realized as we were watching this show, lightsaber battles used to be like, oh shit, you know, this is a really big deal. Now it's just like, yeah, it's just like any other encounter, any other fight.
Part of writing is being able to have those moments where you have a villain and a hero communicating, talking, or in some way interacting with each other that doesn't end the show. You have to come up with reasons why. And in a world where you have long distance communication that's extremely prevalent, you would think that there'd be plenty of ways for them to have back and forth. Or maybe there's a reason one of them can't kill the other. Like, what if they both had parts of the map and they each needed each other's part or something like that? What if you had some reason for the villains to keep the heroes alive but to follow them, or vice versa? Where, you know, we can't kill the other side because of, you know, X reason. We need such and such person. They are the ones who only know, you know, such and such detail or information. You got to sit down really in the writing room and you got to think about it. How do we mix it up?
They can't get Ezra without the help of the bad guys, and the bad guys can't get Thrawn without the help of the good guys.
You sit down in the writer's room and you think of how you could make the story in some way interesting to a minor degree.
Thinking of ways to create any drama whatsoever, I don't think is particularly difficult. Like, so it's kind of a miracle that Ahsoka just has no drama whatsoever going on.
Yeah, I agree, actually.
Yeah, you think you'd accidentally have something dramatic happen.
She's not even pretending like she has something conflicting going on.
Most of the time she's on screen, doesn't even look like she's bothered about anything. She's like, whatever.
The only time I've seen her emote is like a little smirk every now and then, in like wildly different contexts, so I don't know what it really means.
But a smirk is like just enough expression to where it doesn't count as an expression.
I haven't watched all of Clone Wars, but Ahsoka was very different.
I think they want to like sell the idea that she's done some growing up or something, but it doesn't really map when nothing about who she was, even as like a young adult, is even remotely present in the person she is now. So there really isn't much of a person here now.
You know, when people grow up, they just turn into boring losers, right?
Well, they get old, and I've heard old is like the worst thing that can happen to you in any universe. It just turns you into either a coward or a blank slate.
Yeah, in Star Wars, you gotta be worried.
Never be old. I was gonna say as well, by the way, after the first two episodes, like, we've got hyper confirmation and connections to the Republic about like the dangers of a resurgence in the Empire, and that they're desperately, actively searching for Thrawn, which is seen as like a, you know, he's a figure that combined Empire remnants together. So what I'm trying to say is that, like, this should go well beyond our three main characters now.
Where's Luke?
Absolutely, Luke. Luke would be invested as fuck in stopping this from happening, but we can't afford him.
Especially once the
episode 8. Maybe he will. Maybe they'll bring him back.
Hope not.
They already know that the Sith are involved, which means Luke needs to be involved.
Yep.
That'd be the first thing they do. It was like, oh shit, there's Sith around. I wonder what they were doing during the original trilogy.
No, he's busy on his swamp island pretending to be Yoda.
Just imagining Luke hearing about all of this because of the way the Jedi were like described to him and the idea he had about them, because they were like this ancient order that's kind of gone in his life and his understanding until he became the last Jedi in a way. So what does he think when suddenly it's like, no, actually there's like 15 of them running around still. There's a bunch of those Sith still too, if you want to get on top of that.
It would rock his world, and we don't get to see any of it.
Sabine,
wake up. You need to defuse this bomb.
Sabine, wake up. You've got to solve all plot problems. Don't remind me of all this. It was so stupid. Remember when she needed to blow up a hospital?
If the robot waited, they wouldn't have a lead.
Remember how thin this lead was? The droid.
How it immediately worked. Remember how she described these fuckers as being here because greed, and then they actively defend. Do you think they're there for greed and money if they did that?
Why would the window shatter like that if she used her lightsabers to cut through it? It should just make two, like, long holes.
Isn't that interesting, right? Though? They said for the Empire, as in, like, they believe in it.
We got a taste of that idea maybe happening.
As a joke in Mando.
In one episode of Mando. Yeah, and then it never went in there.
God, imagine that they had to work with a character who was Empire-affiliated and actually believed in them.
Well, remember they had that one episode in Mandalorian, season 3, episode 3, where they had the rehabilitation program. And I was like, oh, that's something.
That was something.
I just get concerned because you start talking like that, and then I imagine if you told them that, they would just hear, oh, we should put Cyril in Ahsoka, you're right, yeah.
No!
Ooh, a warm wormhole.
Don't put spooky whales.
Oh,
Okay. He said, set. But this should eat up another 5 minutes or so.
Why are you swinging at his weapon?
I'm not sure what this proves or achieves.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'd have to explain to me what this is supposed to do.
Not bad. If you say so.
Was the goal to make them as straight as possible?
I don't even know why that would matter.
Some of them are orange and some were like bright. Lightsaber. I don't know if that means anything.
Your skill with a weapon comes from your Mandalorian upbringing.
Why would you say that to her? Wouldn't she think that and know that?
You're training the body, but you must also open your mind.
Oh God, such generic lines.
Here we go.
Open your mind!
Learning to wield the Force takes a deeper commitment.
So she is gonna learn to use the Force then.
She's gonna be the blindfold training.
She called her Padawan last episode.
According to Hu Yang, I'm the worst candidate to be a Jedi out of every Jedi he's ever known.
By the end of the season, she's going to be the leader of the Thieves Guild, the Jarl of Whiterun. She's going to run the Fighter's Guild.
By the way,
she'll be the mayor.
This is a criticism from Plinkett that I completely agree with, where he said, in A New Hope, it was a fashioned sort of training thing that Obi-Wan just came up with on the spot. But suddenly it's become like the most known and fundamental training method for any Jedi ever.
Star Wars has been flanderized a lot like that.
Yeah.
Why don't you just have her wear this for like a day and try to navigate through the ship and do things with the Force?
No, one scene doing this and then it'll pay off one time later where she detects someone in darkness.
Do you know where I am?
Next to Hu Yang.
Are you sure?
Oh, so
you can project voices into people's heads? And why would you hear it directionally if it's just in your mind? The reason we hear from directions is because sound waves hit one ear before the other.
She can do it because of the Force.
Feel my presence.
Oh, is it Christmas?
How does she go about doing that?
Take in all that is around you.
How?
You must feel the Force.
I know it's kind of hard to go into, but explain.
No.
I just want to see a dark side training session. I'm bored of the light side ones. They're all the same.
That would be interesting.
Yep.
Wouldn't it be cool to see a fucking light side Force person not teach at all like this? It's always like this.
Because remember, you have, like, in theory, Order 66 killed all the Jedi and all the Sith are dead now. So you have all these, like, Force-sensitive people in the galaxy. Mm-hmm. Like, how do they, like, get on? Like, oh, I can use the Force, but how do I... It's like they have to restart almost. They have to figure out how to use the Force again and use their powers. And
even Yoda did like strength and agility and stuff.
Well, yeah, he had all the things where Luke had to work on his balance and he had to stand on his upside down on one arm while lifting a rock. And he had to do flips and carry Yoda around. Jesus Christ.
Ow.
How did you? Wow. How do you?
It's the Force.
What are you doing?
Why does the robot blink?
Because he's an interesting guy. He's my favorite character in the show.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. He's...
Who's your second favorite?
That was a really slow reaction.
I don't know.
I was gonna say, there's no second favorite because no one else qualifies.
That was so interesting.
Yeah, we've eaten
up. Isn't that insane you were able to do
make
that?
An expression?
Dude, we're at 6.5 minutes. We really have eaten through the time already.
Anger and frustration are quick to give power. But they also unbalance you.
Wow. Explain what that means relative to combat.
They're building character, don't you understand?
Hasn't she done all of this already, though?
This is the Padawan stuff? I've heard all this before. This is all the most basic Jedi shit.
We've seen it all before, and I'm pretty sure they've done it before because that seems like fundamental basics. And she was a Padawan with her for at least, what, like a year or something?
Yeah, that was apparently not in Rebels, by the way. That was between Rebels and this.
Which is an interesting choice. I don't know why you wouldn't start it up here.
Even before that, though, she did Jedi training with Kanan very briefly. She wielded the Darksaber. Darksaber's in that show, by the way.
Woohoo!
Is this the only outfit you have?
Yes. The main character outfit. We don't get.
If you're a general, shouldn't you be dressed like a general?
Look, it's Mon Mothma.
No.
Oh fuck.
Hera, you look well. How's young Jason?
Look, they've acknowledged his son.
Fine, Chancellor. In fact, he's on board. Somewhere.
This is a military vessel.
Causing trouble with Chopper, no doubt.
I don't want to hear Mon Mothma say Chopper's name.
My investigation into the attack on the Vesper led me to the Sante shipyard.
She's just the Sith are back. The Empire's reforming.
Where I was attacked by Imperial loyalists still working for Morgan Elspeth.
All right, well, let's interrogate them and see what they know.
First strike. Double kill. Triple kill. Overkill.
We have former Imperials working throughout every level of the New Republic.
Well, these guys are going for Thrawn, though.
Long live the Empire doesn't sound like the kind of loyalty we're looking for.
Okay, we've established those ones would attack you.
I believe their activity speaks to a larger...
We know.
It always does.
Involving Thrawn.
What do you mean it always does?
Don't we know these things? It's not
Grand
believing,
Admiral Thrawn.
No, Frankie Thrawn, my brother.
What's he gonna do without an army? He's just
a
guy,
blue
right?
man.
Yeah, but he's a really spooky blue man.
He could be on Thanos planet farming gooseberries or whatever. Yeah. Whatever, you know?
If I could get approval to send a task force to the Denap system, I could find out.
Obviously approved.
Isn't this just another attempt to gain New Republic resources to aid in what has ultimately been your personal quest to find Ezra Bridger?
No, did you not Ezra hear all the words that I said?
Ezra vanished while fighting Thrawn.
And that you conveniently use.
No, I just need
you conveniently use Thrawn. It's like it's not convenient.
Use a threat of Thrawn's return to acquire those resources that could be put to a more practical purpose.
Like, what?
Is he saying he needs proof?
Were you ever in the war, Senator?
No.
Just sat back and waited to see who came out on top.
Sat back, that bastard. So did Mon Mothma. Look at you all, pathetic. I don't know what that had to do with Thrawn, though.
Also, if you're just going to insult them, that's not going to get you...
I was going to say, that it doesn't really have anything to do with what was being discussed.
And we also don't know the context of his involvement. Maybe there was nothing he could do, or the Imperials were breathing down his neck all the time.
The Imperial fleet is scattered and broken. They have no centralized command.
Unless Thrawn
returns.
Yeah,
but they wanted to get one. Yeah, exactly.
Do they not have...
If
she only needs proof... Then provide it, right?
Thrawn is not your typical Imperial officer.
Yeah, he's a good one.
I know because I him. He killed friends, people who were like family to me.
Yeah,
that
all
wow.
of them do. What
you
do you mean?
You were in a war. Yes, there were soldiers in a war.
Are you going to mention those Sith you were encountering?
Most of your life fighting a war, it was 3 years.
That's
right?
Wait,
or
that
six,
was it?
6 years?
That was
or
how
something?
She made Thrawn
that's
seem
it?
Special, is that he killed people she liked?
It is my opinion that your friend Ezra Bridger heroically died with him.
You don't know that.
How has the story become that they died?
I'm so confused.
Allow me a moment to speak with my colleagues.
You are not a good negotiator.
But genuinely, the impression I got was they don't believe it. So can we get proof?
Can I get an investigator? And then if the
investigator... Yeah, let me have one scout ship or whatever, scout team to go to the...
Yeah.
They tracked the fucking ship, guys. Hello?
Mom! Is it true Aunt Sabine is going to be a Jedi?
Is your hair green?
Yeah, because he's half Twi'lek.
That's how that works.
Is that what happening to get green hair?
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Humans and Twi'leks are compatible genetically?
Yeah, let's not think about that.
Don't think about it. Of course, he didn't turn out to be hideously, you know, scarred and half of each creature. He turned out to just be a guy
like...
with a green tint in his hair.
That scene was annoying. It felt like they were all talking past each other.
It's delays. What would have happened is that she tells them, as a respected general, I have very strong reason to believe that Thrawn has been brought back in. We're tracking a ship that's going to reach him. We need a team. And they provide resources.
Can I get
simple
resources
as that.
To go get
in fact,
him? And they're like, "Well, we're short on resources."
Shouldn't she have the power to summon a team of some kind?
She's a general. Whatever that means.
She said nothing was classified to her, so.
And again, she's a general. That's
well,
like
and
a
it wouldn't take long to
high title in a military
to get people to do it on their own preference as well. It's Thrawn.
Force resides in all living things, even you.
Okay.
All right.
Uh-huh.
Another pause.
Right.
If that's true, then why doesn't everyone use it?
Oh, we're doing this?
Talent is a factor.
Talk!
Words!
How doesn't she know this already?
But training and focus are what truly define someone's success.
What were you teaching her that whole time?
Thoughtful music.
Thoughtful music, that's... that's your opinion show.
Not everyone can handle the type of discipline it takes to master the ways of the Force.
Whoa.
Wow, she moved a cup a little.
Start small.
What does that mean?
How do I start small? What does that mean?
A
can
cup.
You, like,
bad teacher.
Once you can move the cup, you'll be able to move buildings.
Ahsoka. I'm going to give this my best.
Do you call her your first name?
Fucking better.
Mrs. Tano, right? Or Miss Tano? I don't know.
Or Master, because, you know, she's
Master Tano.
Yeah, she should be calling him Master, right?
I just kind of call her Hey You.
Any word from her about our support from the New Republic?
No, not yet.
Can you communicate while you're in hyperspace with other ships that are not in hyperspace?
I think we've been shown they can do that before, I think.
What do you think of our progress?
She's frustrated. Still a challenge for her.
Do you really need to tell us now that she's frustrated and it's not easy for her? We just saw that. You took 15 minutes to get... Okay, 13 minutes.
The Jedi Order would not have accepted her. She is not an acceptable candidate.
I thought he was the one encouraging her to do it last episode.
Isn't she already fucking amazing enough without being a Jedi?
Now he's like, she wouldn't be accepted.
Was it more so Hera who was encouraging it?
Well, but he gave her the lightsaber and he was like, do it, loser.
I don't need Sabine to be a Jedi.
I suppose you do come from a long line of non-traditional Jedi.
By a long line, do you mean her and then Anakin?
That's if there are 2 points, then the line in between.
Oh, to be fair, maybe they count Qui-Gon too.
I was gonna say, does Qui-Gon count?
She's gonna do it like right away.
It's gonna nudge.
Force is in all of us.
Shut up.
Oh, shut
I don't
up.
Know. Yeah. I don't know like the process. I can't relate to this in any way. I have no mental concept of what she's supposed to be thinking.
She's got to think about how the force is in all of us.
Okay. Have the least make it fail.
Training sequence where it's just yeah, just do the thing. Do it.
Yeah,
you didn't
we don't
do
know
it.
What
now
she's
try
thinking.
Again and do it.
I have no idea what we're supposed to conceptualize her thoughts as.
It's so funny as well because of like how if we actually had a Jedi who at best could only slightly move a cup and they've been training for like their whole lives, that would create a lot of really great emotional tension for him.
Yeah,
what if
Ahsoka right
gave
away.
Her like a feather and is like, when you can move this
yeah.
feather, we'll
yeah.
talk.
Well, props, it didn't nudge.
Mm-hmm. Restraint.
Unfortunately, I won't be joining you for this one.
Yeah, I think it's so weird that you're able to communicate what? While you're in hyperspace.
The Senate committee wouldn't approve the mission.
They won't
it's
approve the mission.
Strange.
They're literally tracking the stolen hyperspace stuff to people who intend to go to Thrawn, but the Republic don't care.
But it's not up to me. I don't follow the order.
Hera?
Okay.
We've entered the Denab system. All comm transmissions are being jammed.
Wait, hang on. So their comms are jammed and they're going to basically... They don't even know where they're going. They don't know what's going to be here.
Imagine
it could be
they
like...
come out and it's just a Star Destroyer.
Yeah, they could just get killed.
I love that.
They're not get, they just got confirmed blast. They're not having backup.
Yeah.
Don't you guys think this is dangerous?
Why'd we drop out of hyperspace so far from the planet?
Because of course you drop out of hyperspace far from a planet, because people can detect when you drop out of hyperspace. This has been a rule since Empire Strikes Back.
Oh my god, they're actually making fun of him for being careful.
Standard Jedi mission protocol when approaching an unknown situation.
That's yeah. Jedi protocol?
Yeah.
No, that's
just normal person protocol. They're all gonna die. I don't see how they don't die here.
Oh, never mind.
They're just
then.
Gonna
oh,
die.
Here we go.
Oh,
it's
we're dying.
We're
what was that? Six? So that means we've got four we can blow up because, yeah, special
oh,
lady
it's
and
oh, it's Alice.
Special man.
I am tracking two squadrons of three crafts.
So say six, please.
This is stupid.
Why are you smirking?
Because it's fun. It's Star Wars.
You can't emote.
Man, I can't think of another time
tail gun or anything.
That this might be referencing. I wonder.
I see you got rid of my presets. I never needed them. So you say?
We're so quick.
Bum, 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 bum.
So they're fucked. It's 6-on-1. There's no way.
Yeah, it's over.
No, they're just all going to miss and then they die.
And they are.
What, they just shot a little bit?
That was exactly how it was shot in a New Hope.
Yeah, I feel like I've seen this scene before, fellas.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Still familiar.
That's kind of remarkable, actually.
It's boring. He keeps doing this. It's like the fifth significant thing he's just taken from A New Hope. I like the shots are just doing nothing. They won't
yeah,
do anything
why is it
ever.
Not doing anything?
It's shields. They matter this time.
The way you're both acting, there won't be a later.
Oh my god, that expression. Rosario, please. I know you can
no,
act.
Why are you going super fast? Get above it and then shoot down. It's space.
Tell me what you need.
Move on my signal?
Copy.
Oh, it's so
swear. Oh, we'll just follow you.
Uh-huh. Yeah, they can move like that too.
If anything, they're more maneuverable, because of course they're more maneuverable. Wow.
Okay. Don't worry about it, you'll get another chance. We got two more incoming. Dead ahead.
Dude, she's had the same like emotional wait. Expression throughout this whole scene.
I'm gonna split them.
Woo! I got one!
Good work!
This is uh-huh. like, but they can't, you're like,
they don't
you
care.
Seem vulnerable.
Nobody
to all
cares.
Damage.
They're at a cartoon scene where there's no stakes at all.
They yeah. can't hurt you. Apparently, you're invulnerable to their little lasers. Nothing's happening.
No,
when
we're
they...
entering phase two now. The ship's going to get damaged or something by a random shot.
Yeah, probably.
Looks like the same as all of the other ones.
Oh, look at
oh
that.
Oh my god.
She just
okay.
raided them.
We should be able to make visual confirmation now.
This is so shit.
It's
why did you just now get a visual confirmation?
Yeah, that...
If I had to guess, I would say it is some sort of hyperspace ring.
I am so bored.
They should have been destroyed ages, like seven times
oh, you
over.
Guys are still here, huh?
Yeah, there's still one more they can destroy.
Morgan, they're entering your sector.
Your sector?
Does this thing have guns?
This whole thing a sector?
I'm surprised you let them get this far.
Well, apparently our lasers
you let
don't
them get this far?
To enemy ships.
It's called plot armor, love.
You're gonna deal with them.
Do we not have missiles or anything?
Oh boy, here we go.
Oh, you're so double dead now.
Miss,
yeah.
miss.
Firm up on my wing and wait for my signal.
Oh my god, the
oh,
voice
he's got a voice modulator too.
Hello, Ezra.
Fighters have broken off. You better get up here.
Copy.
What's your plan here anyway? Now you found this thing.
What
can
it be
now?
Subversive and make him go, as you wish.
Turbo lasers, primed and ready.
open fire.
So they're fucked. They're absolutely fucked.
Well, no, Rags, they're flying straight at them. That's the last thing they'd expect.
What's that? They're like laser flak guns.
They did that last time as well. I didn't know those existed.
They're doing the World War II thing again because you saw the planes lift up. I called them planes. Why not just the spaceships chasing them?
Why not just have them shoot actual shells that explode? Yeah. They don't have to be lasers. Just use flak.
Well, it wouldn't matter. They're moving right at them, which means they can't hit them.
Oh, that's true. That's true, yeah.
No matter what weapon you use, if someone comes right at you, it's just going to miss.
What's the point if this isn't destroying the ship? What's the point of lasers? What's the point of lasers?
What is the point of anything? We did this already in episode really 2. Like, this exact thing of just a bunch of lasers just completely missed.
This is intolerable.
You want it closer. Deflectors at 10%.
Oh, that's just how long it takes?
Jesus
how do space battles not all take like a week?
Well, yeah, and why don't everybody get the deflectors of this ship?
Just a moment. Scan complete.
Damage that won't mean anything minutes from now.
Destroyed.
They are off our scope.
How are they off your scope?
No, how are they off your scope? How? What
the fuck are you talking about?
They're right. They're in you.
They're right in the middle. Inside the ring. You can't see inside your own ring.
You can't look out the window.
I have no idea where they are.
I hate this shit. It's so sad.
Wait, why would it have slowed down? It's space.
I need you to run a full diagnostic.
Leave.
Prioritize Sabine. We can't help Wu Yang if we're both dead. Now get on it.
Also, God, you could sound like you give a shit. Come on.
Congratulations. You almost got them.
Oh yeah, then go finish them off. You're right out there. Kill them.
We'll take it from here.
Man, she seems
all
like
you, they were chasing them, right? So they just see a floating ship. It's easy. Kill them.
Yeah, they would have seen it.
And by the way, if they're down, you don't need to like fly around. You can just stop in front of them and just start shooting. Just go do 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 do.
Oh what? Hang on.
Oh no.
She just said I'm going out there. Don't.
To do a repair like an EVA. She's gonna put on a spacesuit and try and fix it from the
gonna happen.
Yeah, lightsaber fight spaceships.
They've done it before in Visions, right? It's about time we do it in live action.
No. Wait, she's gonna go there with a lightsaber?
Oh.
And fight them?
Yeah, actually. Oh.
No.
Oh, no, man.
Oh, she has a special.
No.
Oh,
no.
No.
What? No, you're joking.
No.
Right? Why are you walking like normal?
You're in space currently.
Oh no.
But no, you can't deflect like cannons with lightsabers, right? Yeah. It's way too big.
Okay, now especially just shoot the ship multiple. Where she isn't. No, shoot where she isn't.
My.
What?
What?
That's not how that works. You float, you jump the. No, no.
She's got a.
Where she isn't.
If she has gravity
ship.
Boots or something, is that what they're.
Whatever.
This is so shit. Oh, look
at
her.
Why are you aiming at her?
Oh.
Oh, calm the
you didn't
fuck
need
on.
To drive by.
Dude,
you could just stop and shoot.
Why did you get within lightsaber range?
That was your
you're
caring
in a spaceship.
Face. Oh, that looks real.
God, fucking hate this character.
Did you see her face when she thought she might be dead? She was like, oh no.
I got it.
A slight piece of emotion. Thank you.
Great.
No, pull the light. No, pull the ship with the force.
You can't kill any more, Ahsoka. Those two are main characters.
Leia can
so
do
where
it.
Are
why
your
can't you?
Did you lose them, or are we not going to think about that?
Oh, the, she has them. It's fine.
I know why she lost them. How is that? Why is that not doing any damage?
I don't know, man.
Disruptor fields,
no
force, crammer
it's
beams.
It's good that this hyperdrive machine cycle only has guns on one side.
What was the trick?
It's
always on a timer.
Enemy pilots to shoot at the one
maybe
Jedi.
She bypassed the compressor.
I just don't understand.
We're still going.
Yeah, by the way, nothing is actually going to progress in this episode, is it?
No, nothing.
Nope. I don't think so.
We have
remember
less than 10 minutes
in A New Hope, wasn't it like 3 TIE fighters were a huge deal for the Millennium Falcon?
Oh no, the whales.
What the fuck? How are you flying?
It's the hyperspace whales, don't worry.
Yeah, Rags, it makes sense.
Are they just gonna hitch a ride? Please don't.
It's just so much money to be spent on crap.
Look at them, they're so
they're
many.
Just here?
Even
just,
he's like, what the fuck is this? What show am I in?
The planet where they're from.
The whale planet.
What's to even be said? It's so boring.
Not
dude,
to be that guy, but
have you noticed as well the way
like this ever exists?
The sound of their guns firing is like it's like pathetic.
Yeah, very weak. And they don't show them doing any damage, so that doesn't help. They sound weak, and they apparently are just really, really weak, and they can't hit a goddamn thing.
Nope.
Why is it meant to be?
What the fuck is that?
What?
Why did you do this?
Wait, that editing was interesting. They were about to die.
They were about to die.
How long is this gonna go?
An opening
time. We gotta waste time. Waste as much time as possible.
What happened to your cannon? Use your cannon.
Oh, they lost him. Nice one, guys. She's had the same expression for three episodes, that lady.
Wait, what is that HUD supposed to be?
I don't actually know how it helps at all.
Weird random tunnel.
No, well, you're thinking, like, where you are have, they? Like, you didn't have to say it.
Don't you have some sort of a screen that shows
no.
you?
No.
That won't lose them for long.
Okay.
Why wouldn't it?
Why?
Why would you're it lose them planet. For anything?
Oh, he's just better now.
What did I miss?
We almost died.
Multiple times.
Damn, that's hilarious.
He fought ships in space with her lightsabers.
That's something they did, yeah. I streamed a game today, and some people told me this episode was much better than the first two.
I mean, it's shorter, so I agree. To you?
It's shorter, that's true. Yeah.
Why, is it because there was lasers and lightsabers
why is there
more?
There's restraint. There's no restraint.
Because this is Dave Filoni making a show about his OC. He's never going to show restraint.
This is unbelievable. Like, all the progress we made in half a fucking hour is they followed the tracker to the planet and landed. We could have done this in the opening scene.
Why does she
Take
have
your
an
time,
Imperial
guys.
Insignia on the... No, they can sense the heat signature of the ship and everything. And the Force, they could sense your Force presence, right?
Nah.
Are you really just looking visually?
They can't look down, though. The cockpit is covering everything up.
They must be hiding in the forest. Let's regroup.
Hey, can we get a scan of the planet for the ship or something? There's no continuity of technology, I feel. There's just no... It's just whatever is whenever. Every single episode is just whatever happens, happens, I guess. Why did you not keep it off? What if they turn around and make another pass?
I was going to say, if padding is still here.
There are six hyperdrive engines in place, with the final one being set into position.
So there's three on the side and a seventh on the bottom?
A craft with these power levels and configuration would be capable of a hyperspace jump of astonishing speed and distance.
Shouldn't this be enough for the Republic to get involved?
Yeah, wouldn't these have been built before?
Remember, you just sent the schematic.
Nah, it's jammed. Signal's jammed. Remember?
Well, then hyperspace back.
No, none of that.
The Jedi Archives speak of intergalactic hyperspace lanes between galaxies, which used to follow the migration paths of star whales named Purgles.
Star whales. Don't call them that in
because we can't,
universe, please.
Because we can't use our incomprehensible computing power to just, like,
ooh,
come up
music.
With a lane.
Are they going to end up using the star whales to destroy the hyperspace ring?
Oh, no, we're using that ring because we got to get to Thrawn.
Jedi have taken refuge in the forest.
It's not going to do it for fucking ages.
Hunt them down. Next episode, then.
No, you come with us because you're a Jedi and also you can sense the Force presence of Ahsoka.
Okay, so I'm going to stand here.
It's going to be them in the forest,
yeah,
isn't it?
It'll actually have to be at least episode 6 before the fucking ring is used.
Ahsoka and this guy will have a fight and it will be very dramatic, but both
very
of them
epic.
Will walk
whenever
right
you're
from
ready,
the
holy fuck.
Yeah, but he's looking mischievous and evil and sinister.
Damn.
That's it. Yeah, we did it. Yep, there
nothing.
You go.
That's
it.
That
was
nothing.
Really bad.
Fucking
that was
nothing episode. We just had the Republic say nah, and then we arrived on the planet. That's it.
Yeah, that's all we did.
No, it was
but,
a little combat
I mean,
filler, but ultimately...
How could you leave out that Sabine was doing her training?
Yeah, she learned
training
so much.
That I thought she already had, but apparently she was brand new learning about how anyone can have the Force.
I mean,
she didn't know that.
Isn't it incredible the restraint that they showed that she couldn't use the Force in this episode, but by the end of the season she'll be very good at it.
Oh, absolutely.
She'll move a cup.
By the end of the season she's going to beat one of these established like Sith kind of people or
like
something.
Yeah, with the Force probably. But you see that they could have had her be really good at it in this episode, but they're
like,
bravo.
Such a passionless show. It feels like it's gone to the point where I think they told Rosario Dawson, like, do not show too much emotion. Ahsoka is a character at this point that's very, very, like, stoic and strong. She wouldn't let her emotions control her now. She's supposed to be the one that everyone else learns from or something. Because I don't know how
wouldn't
else this happened.
But wouldn't it be interesting if she wasn't like that?
Yeah, it would.
Especially because she's not a Jedi technically, right? She left the Order.
Yeah.
So it'd be kind of interesting if she was kind of forging out her own path and her own way of embodying the ideals of the Jedi without necessarily being, I guess, archetypal. That seems like an opportunity, but it seems like they've foregone that opportunity. Everybody's just dull and boring. I like the robot and don't like anybody else.
Yeah. Oh, can I make a prediction?
No.
Sure.
They're going to... fail to stop the hyperspace ring and it fucks off and they're still there, so they have to use the space whale to get to Thrawn and use like force manipulation to use one of those space whales to get there.
I think that's,
I think you're on that.
A space sequence was so terrible.
It was so boring.
They just keep lowering the stakes. I don't think I've ever seen a
worse depiction of space combat. I just, what's the point? What's the point of guns? What is the point of having guns?
What are we doing when we spend 10 minutes when it's just moving left and right, up and down, as all of the pew, 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 and it's always missing, and then they get damaged, it gets repaired in like 3 minutes, and then back to woo, 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 like and weaving and moving left and right, but and then, oh look, it's the whales. That's an escalation, except the same thing is still happening. They're just moving around while the bad guys keep missing.
They miss forever. Minutes. I just don't understand how you miss that much. It's not that it matters because their guns are useless.
It's got to be emphasized again. Ahsoka fought spaceships with her lightsabers. She deflected their shots and was jumping around with her gravity boots, I guess, chopping up a ship as it was flying past.
I still can't believe I saw that, but it did happen. I was there. That wouldn't happen.
Someone wrote this and thought it was okay.
They do that a lot. They do
that. That action scene actually lasted for about half the episode.
Yeah.
It started about halfway. And it basically concluded just at the end of the episode. It kept going. It was about 15 minutes.
I can't get over how shit that from Ahsoka was. I just can't get over it. That's, you could have let her say something a bit more impassioned when she thinks their lives are on the line, you know? You could.
It's almost as though the writers know that their lives aren't on the line, and therefore the characters know that too.
Yeah, they treat it like a joke. Like, haha, we almost died.
The tension on the Millennium Falcon when it was being pursued by 3 TIE fighters in A New Hope was
famous.
It is famous.
Misunderstand. So, like, when Luke shouts, you know, I got one, that because he's happy that he got one, that they misunderstand that to be, so they should all be pretty happy-go-lucky during this whole thing, not realizing that that was after, like, a minute of just tense action.
I wonder if anyone is going to have the balls to post, like, the images from A New Hope and images from this and be like, I love the intertwining of, you know, these themes and these... these reflections, these echoes through time, and just be like, shut the fuck up.
You know somebody's gonna do that.
They tried it again in The Force Awakens, so it's already been copied.
Yeah, and it's boring. Yeah,
like, when Luke is, you know, when he's ecstatic that he was able to get one, he even, like, turns around and he's, like, almost, he distracts himself with how happy it is that he was able to get one. And then you get the reply from Han Solo as he's like, yeah, kid, don't get cocky. He's focusing on him flying the Millennium Falcon, and he's trying to get him to you know, to focus again. And again, that was 3 TIE fighters, 3 basic bitch TIE fighters pursuing them through an asteroid field.
I don't think they were in an asteroid field, right? That's the 6 second of them.
Oh, yeah. Wait,
let's do 6, and there's no asteroids, and they still miss. And if they hit, it doesn't do anything. Then they get shot by flak lasers, whatever the fuck that is. You get half exploded, and it's like, oh, did we destroy them? They're out of scopes. Like, what the fuck do you mean they're out of scope? They're like, inside
in
of you.
The ring.
In the ring.
You can't see the inside of your ring, you like the retard?
Most viewable moment. Most scannable.
You might be behind the ring, they still don't get shot, because I guess those gobble blasters can't turn around, even though it looked like they could.
How was Hu Yang damaged, but nothing in the cockpit is damaged? You know what I mean?
Because
I have no idea.
They do sparks or whatever, but I don't see how he got damaged.
The ship didn't sustain any real damage. Like, the ship looks fine in the subsequent chase between the whales. It doesn't look like it was shot at.
It's funny, because after they get disabled for a little bit, there's, like, debris flying around, but it's, like, so tiny, and there's nothing on the ship that indicates where it's coming from. Look at this. What is that?
Oh, yeah, the ship. There's no damage on the ship. The model, like, nothing's broken on the back. It looks like it's just a ship, but it shows debris. But I think debris comes from something. So if you look out your window and you see pieces of your ship floating around, that means they're no longer attached to your ship. Something's broken.
And I mean, if it's like you said, if there were sparks and a big, like, shock from the front, they're real lucky that that glass didn't break, otherwise they'd be dead.
And yeah, by the way, the Republic conversation was basically, I want more soldiers to go and stop the potential rise of Thrawn. And they're like, I mean, you know,
man, that's convenient that Thrawn comes up now, so you can have a resource. Like, what?
They don't believe that Thrawn is actually there, and that they think she's going for Ezra.
That's not good that they have that little trust in.
Yeah, you'd think that she'd have some sway, but I guess not.
Did she mention that there are Sith
There are multiple Sith with the red lights and everything. There's three of them.
She didn't even mention it, I don't think, did she?
I guess it's just really awkward that you feel like her word would be worth a lot in and of itself. Yeah. That she
made her a general.
Exactly. Now we've got probably one of the most expensive pieces of tech in history. One of them, obviously, there's lots. It's a device that's likely going to break records in terms of hyperspace travel. And we know why they're doing it. I just find it unreal that she couldn't even manage to get them to give her a group of people to just test all this out, see what's going on.
Someone of you guys already pointed out, she's a general. She could have probably just said, like, hey, you one ship, you go with them.
Why didn't she go? She went on the last mission.
She probably will go. That would be my guess, that they had the, you know, how they did the signal getting cut out, that she'll personally go so that she can be part of the team when they go to the other galaxy. They'll probably want to keep her around.
And I don't see how, with who she is and what she's done, that she wouldn't be able to muster up in the same way they do in Rogue One. Remember, it's like they deny the mission and then they just do it anyway because a bunch of people are willing and interested. Yeah. How would you not be able to say, like, they're trying to get Thrawn, the idiots at the top don't believe me for some reason, I need help.
Does this take place after Mando season 3? Because if it does, they would have to know about everything that was happening on Mandalore, that there was, like, Empire remnants that was gathering.
The insane strength.
A secret base there, and that the Mando stopped them, sure. But I mean, if they know about that, then they have to know that there is actually some amount of organization happening, that the Empire remnants are beginning to gather up in a way that might be dangerous.
Yeah, and if you just ignore them, they're not just going to go away. They're going to try and organize. So you can't say, yeah, whatever, we'll deal with it later or whatever.
They said there's a lot of Imperial remnants they got to take care of, which is like, I buy that, but obviously she's saying Thrawn's more important. For some reason, they need to be convinced of that. I don't know the state of Thrawn in universe anymore. He goes from...
Well, he's said, like, oh, Grand Admiral Thrawn. Like, she seemed worried. She knew who he was.
Yeah, so at that point, it's just about proof, I guess. And it's like, go get it.
You'd think that they would let her take one ship. That was a fleet.
One ship.
Also,
one
ship. And this is a character commentary, I think, that she knows her two very good friends are heading into a place where she can't communicate with them and may very well be a force that's intending on getting Thrawn. Shouldn't she think they're dead or dying?
Absolutely.
Well, that's what I'm saying. She'll come. But,
she should have come already. The second they say, we're not sending anyone with you, she'd be like, right, and leaves and gets into her own ship. And to be honest with you, like, Ahsoka and Sabine shouldn't have gone, because there's no reason to think they'd live.
She doesn't seem to understand the urgency, because she doesn't really express it in the meeting with Mon Mothma and the rest of them either.
She will show up at the end of the episode to save those two when they get in trouble. That's my guess now.
Yeah, so we can have the Rebels reunion.
Maybe we'll see Thrawn next episode.
Maybe at the end of the episode, it's like, ooh, they're coming.
Yeah, I can believe. Or maybe next, you know. Who knows when he's going to show up?
I can't get over that they're treating, like, a pretty smart general with this godlike reverence, as if just finding him is going to swing the tide entirely just because he exists.
Well, it's funny, they have full permission to kill him whenever they want to, because he's not in the sequels, so...
But nobody's ever really gone.
It's true. Imagine an angle where this is a sort of desperation thing for the Imperials. We're kind of directionless and scattered. If there's anyone who can form some sort of substantial resistance out of all of these disparate elements, it's going to be him. Rather than just, yeah, we're gonna get him, and when we do, we're just gonna sweep the Republic away.
We're gonna get
They find him, and then he gets brought back, and he just looks at their resources and says, I can't do anything.
Yeah.
Or he just says, listen, I got an idea. I'm gonna call him Snoke.
God, they might do that. They might end some episode with someone
Remember
looking
the,
at saying,
the cloning shit came up with Mando season 3, the Force clones or whatever.
Because they still got their Mando movie that they're building up to.
Oh, no way. A Mando movie?
Yeah, remember? Yeah. Dave Filoni's directing a Mando movie.
And I hate that you reminded me now.
That's going to be incredible, I'm sure.
It's going to be real good.
It's going to be remarkable.
I could stop.
All right, fine. Ahsoka episode 3.
Hooray!
Hooray!
That was really good everyone's time.
I'm excited for episode 4. I can't wait to see what they do in the Red Forest.
What'd you bring me?